In this video, you'll see how to create a private offer using the AWS Marketplace Catalog API. Using the Catalog API, you can create and manage your private offer programmatically, publish your offer, and view its details. This is AWS Cloud Shell, where we're currently signed in to our AWS Marketplace Seller account, which already has AWS Marketplace Catalog API permissions. To get started, let's retrieve all the software as a service products created in this account. Next, let's view the text file containing the results. For demonstration purposes, we'll create a private offer for a SaaS product with a contract-based pricing model. Let's retrieve the information for this specific product. The results contain the entity ID for our product. Let's set the product ID to the entity ID. Next, we'll use the product ID to view the details of the AWS Marketplace product listing. The command returns the product's metadata, including the description, product visibility status, pricing unit dimensions, and any targeted buyer accounts. Next, we'll create a draft private offer for our product. Because the private offer is a modification from the original listing, we'll need to create a change set. A change set allows us to make multiple changes simultaneously. For this example, we've copied a request payload, initiated a create offer change type, and saved the results in a file named createDraftInput.json. Let's view the file. Notice the product ID has been set. Next, we'll start the change set. We'll provide the createDraftInput.json file as an input. The results contain the change set ID, which we'll need in a moment. Next, let's get more details about the change set that we initiated. Notice that we've provided the change set ID as an input. The status of the change set is succeeded, indicating the draft private offer has been created and a private offer ID has been created for our product. Next, we'll update the metadata for the draft private offer. Let's store the private offer ID in a variable. Next, we'll create the payload needed for updating the private offer. Let's view the details of the updateOfferInput.json file we just created. As expected, the file contains the ID of the private offer that we're going to update. It also contains all of the necessary change types. Next, we'll start the change set to update the private offer. We'll provide the updateOfferInput.json file as an input. Notice that a new change set ID has been created. We'll use this ID to check the details of the change type operations that we initiated. The status is currently preparing. Let's clear the terminal and check the status again. The status is now succeeded, indicating all the change types have been executed successfully. Next, we'll publish our private offer to the buyer account. We'll create the request payload required for publishing the private offer. Let's view the details of the releaseOfferInput.json file we just created. The file contains the releaseOffer change type and the offer ID. Now we'll start the change set to publish the private offer. We'll provide the releaseInputOffer.json file as an input. The command returns the change set ID. We'll use this ID to monitor the status of the change set. The status is currently applying. The status is now succeeded, indicating the offer has been released and is in a published state. At this point, an email with the offer details is sent to the buyer who can accept or reject the terms. If the terms are negotiated, a new replacement private offer would need to be created. In this case, the buyer has accepted our offer. Next, let's use the Catalog API to retrieve the details of the published private offer. The details include the offer ID and name, SaaS product ID, and legal terms. We can also see the pricing and payment terms. The details also include the availability end date, targeting rule, and state of the private offer, which is active. This same information is available in the AWS Marketplace Management portal. Let's take a look. We'll navigate to our private offers. The offer we created appears at the top of the list. This page displays the offer details. Here we can see the associated buyer account ID. The section heads correspond to the change types we updated. We can also copy the private offer URL and share it with other potential buyers. You've just seen how to create a private offer using the AWS Marketplace Catalog API. You can learn more about this topic in the description and links for this video. Thanks for watching. Now it's your turn to try.